Good morning and happy Sabbath to all. How many of you are happy that we are in church today? Raise your right hand. Thank you. I am glad that it's Sabbath day, because all from our little activities and be in church today. As I mentioned in December when I was here, I'm an accountant by profession. So I joined accounting. And so today, the message that we're going to hear is about accounting. Wonder if we have some accountants in our midst today. How many accountants do we have here? Do you have any? Nobody? Anybody who works with the accounting related, I'm glad that Ruben is here. Nobody works in the accounting office, accounting clerk, finance department. Yeah, we are here. I guess there are about five of us who are accountants here today. But as we go about the study of God's Word today, let's reflect upon it. Somehow get the message. Because the theme of our study this morning is for us to realize that all of us are accountants before God. Let us pray. Loving God and Father in heaven, we thank you for the opportunity of worship that we have today. Lord, bless all of us and give us wisdom from on high, that somehow the message of the lesson that we are going to hear today will bring us closer to you. In Jesus' name. Amen. The president is in Henderson Highway Church today. And I told him that I will be in West Park SDA Church. And he smiled at me. He said, "Oh, you have been to West Park for two times now." And I told him, "You know what? I was trying to say no. But when Pastor Vizcaro called me up, I remember one time when I was still small in the Philippines. First time I enrolled in Pathfinder, we were grouped into different units. And by the way, we are related to Boy Scouts in the Philippines. And so the Pathfinder leader told us, why don't you group yourselves and put names into your group? And he said, you choose any of the animals that would name your group. And we name our group as Rat, you know, the mouse. And we call ourselves Rat, and we call it Rat Patrol. So the nine of us, now boys, call ourselves Rat Patrol. And our leader always told us that as Pathfinders and as Rat Patrols, we don't have to say no. In Tagalog, we say that one laging handa. Remember? Always prepared. Say no. And so I remember when Pastor Piscaro told me, and I said, this is the second time now. But anyway, the president smiled and he said, yeah, I know, because Filipinos are there. Although this is not a message for Filipinos, this is a message for all of us. And I pray that God would give us wisdom to learn from the things that we are going to study today. Let us actually require a brief message for our meditation this morning. It's always good to have children and kids and young people participate in the work of the church. Because these young people, as Ellen White says, they are the future of the church. Pastor Vizcaro will be out 20 years from now. And I am trying to think that Pastor Vizcaro is already preparing, thinking, what will I do during my retirement? So these children would be trained for church leadership. Anyway, I'd like to imagine this morning, Jesus, beautiful morning, walking beside the sea. And it was in the coast of Caesarea Philippi. And Jesus was there with his disciples. And Jesus asked the question, and he said to his disciples, "Who do you think I am?" So the disciples, Bartholomew said, and Andrew, and the other disciples said, "You know, Jesus, some people said you are Elias or Jeremiah. Or some others say that you are one of the prophets." And Jesus directly told them, "But what about you? What do you think I am?" It was Peter, the bold disciple, who said, "Jesus, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God." When Jesus asked this question, if Jesus asked this question for us today, "Whom do you think I am?" would we be able to say, "Jesus, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God"? You are the Christ, the Son of the living God. When I was at Mountain View College, it was many years now, I happened to read a pamphlet, a small one, which illustrates who Jesus is to different professions and positions of men today. To the traveler, it says, Jesus is the Word. To the preacher, Jesus is the Word, the living Word. To the dying soul, we are told that Jesus is life. To the thirsty, Jesus is water of life, the living water. To the farmer, and I believe we have some farmers here, Jesus is the promised seed, the seed of life. To the weary, Jesus is rest. To the hungry, we are told, Jesus is the bread of life, the manna from heaven. To the doctors, we are told that Jesus is the great physician. To the builders and engineers, we are told that Jesus is the cornerstone, the sure foundation. To the educators, we are told that Jesus is the master teacher. But how about the accountants? Jesus is the balancing figure. Jesus is the balancing figure. I don't know you, whether you know an accountant or not. But let me tell you something about what an accountant is. An accountant is one who records, who summarizes, who analyzes business transactions and undertakings, and prepares and interprets financial statements. That's the work of the accountant. When I started my career as an accountant, by the way, we were still using manual accounting, recording it manually, the journal entries, writing the debit and the credit, and sometimes, writing 43 may be written as 34, or 48 as 84, and 45, 36 may be written as 46, 34. There are errors because we are human beings. And it happened many, many times. One day, at Mountain View College, after my first semester in college, I was one of those privileged to be accepted to work in the accounting office of the school in the Philippines. And so I worked in that department until graduation. After the first year, the chief accountant asked me whether I am agreeable to be the bookkeeper of the school. And I said, "That's no problem as long as you'll help me. I am a student accountant, by the way." And so he helped me. And so I was the bookkeeper of the student accounts. And we have more than 2,300 students in that school. So you could imagine how thick the ledgers are, having 2,300, you know, accounts. To record the debits and the credits, the journal entries, every day. One day, the treasurer told me, "June, you prepare..."